One of the more common questions we get is how do employees get onboarded to self-service password reset so they can use the solution in the event that they forget their password or their username? So what I'm showing you here is the setup questions that everybody must enroll in when they first log into self-service password reset. We can force users to enter these questions the first time they log into their desktop using our client login extension. We'll show you that here in a bit. So these questions can be very customized. So right now I'm showing we have a list here of four. Of course, you can change that. You could have just two, or you could have more. You can also have the end users define their own questions and answers. So I might have here two questions they can choose from a dropdown and two questions they must define and provide the answers for. So the other thing we do is we have lots of checks around these questions. So if somebody enters the answer as part of the name or part of the question itself, that'll be disallowed. We can also check this against word lists if you want to make sure that they don't enter certain items that you deem inappropriate or they're just too common for people to answer with. So very customizable on this side of things. I'm going to go ahead and answer each one of these questions real quick to get this user set up. So first one here, and the second one, we'll say, okay, now that I have those entered, you'll see that it does validate the responses, it meets the requirements, and I'm ready to save the answers. Once I hit save, it'll prompt me with a success that my questions have been saved into the solution. I can hit continue. I'm now shown to the SSPR welcome page. This is what users would see if they log in, and there's different modules here that they have access to. For example, if you wanted to go back to your security questions to clear them out, you can absolutely do that. If there are other options here that you want to choose, for example, we do have the ability here to update the user's profile. So you can define which attributes are exposed here, and then this allows them to come in and edit those on their own. So if you want to have them populate a title, you can do that. I can then update that, and they'll get a confirmation that that has been updated. And next, I want to just take a second to show you how somebody would leverage the client login extensions. So let me go ahead and sign out of this workstation. And you'll see here when I come in here, there's a new forgot my password button. So if I'm not able to remember my password, it's not working, I can click on this button without ever logging in. And from here, I'm now prompted to enter my username. Let me enter the right test user here. Now I have a couple of options here. I can answer the security questions we just provided. I can have an SMS or an email sent to me, or I can do an OAuth verification using our Google Authenticator. So this is leveraging our two-factor authentication solution, Advanced Authentication. So for right now, I'm going to go ahead and answer the questions that we just entered a few minutes ago. It's going to check the answers, and now it's going to allow me to change my password. So from this screen, you can display the current password policy for this user so they can very easily determine what type of password they need to enter. But not only that, we're going to do some calculations of the password that they do enter. So for example, if I enter a password here, you're going to see that over on the right-hand side, we're going to tell you if this password is weak or if it is good, strong, or very strong. And we're also going to tell you when it's going to expire based on your policies. So this is a new feature called Entropy Calculation, and we are able to define different password policies based on the entropy score of the password. So for example, if I have a very simple password like Simplicity1, it's going to expire in the next 90 days. If I were to use a more complex password like the following, you'll see that it also expires in 90 days. If I were to add a couple of digits at the end of it, it now expires in 180 days. So depending upon the score depending upon how difficult the password is that you're entering, you'll get a different policy. And that means, you know, weaker passwords will have to be expired sooner than ones that aren't. So after I go ahead and change my password here, I'll get a confirmation, and then I'll be able to log into my desktop just as usual.